Now let's add those other cats. First, I'll copy all my cats from our last cat clicker, and I'm putting the cat data at the very top of this file. Now I've put the cat data at the top of the file, but I also could load this data from a server, and when the list came back from the server, I could add them to the application. That'd be trivial to implement, and you can do it for extra credit if you want. Now what am I going to do with this array of cat objects? Well, down here in the view model, I'm going to want to create cats. And I'll want to store them in an observable array. I'm going to call it catList. Now you'll notice I'm not passing in the array at the top of the file right into this yet. That's because I need to take that data and make a new cat out of each of those objects. I'm going to loop over all of our initial cats. And for each one of the cats, I'm going to put it into the catList. Here we're doing a very similar thing as we did here. But instead of passing in an object literal, we're passing in each of the cat items in that initial cat array at the top. You'll also notice we're using the var self equals this trick. That way, if we say this.catList, we don't end up getting confused with what this function believes the this keyword maps to. Self is always going to map to the view model. So self.catList is going to map to this catList, this observable array right here. Now, I am forgetting one other thing, which is the nicknames. I'm going to grab our nicknames from Tabby up here, and I'm going to put them in our initial data. I'm also going to add a nickname from Tiger to Tigger, Scaredy to Casper, Shadow to Shuby, and Sleepy to Zzz. Now my initial cat data has nicknames. And in the view model, I'm looping over all the initial cats and pushing a new cat with each of the cat items into the cat list. Pretty good. I'm also going to change this right here to this.catList item 0. That way we're not creating a new cat for the current cat. Here we're making all of the cats we need. We don't need to create another one. We just need to access the 0th element in the cat list, or our first cat. Now we have a bit more work to do. First, we need to make all the cats show up in a list. That should be a list of your cats on the screen that users can click on. You should be able to do that entirely in your HTML with bindings. Second, we need to make the cats in the cat list clickable. When you click on the cat name in the list, it should change the current cat observable to the new clicked cat. That means we'll need to make a function for setting the new current cat. Those are the two main things that you still have to do. Make the cats show up, and make the current cat change when you click on one of those cats in the list. Now, take your time with this one. Don't make a bunch of stabs in the dark. The amount of code you'll need to do all of this is actually pretty small, so take the effort to really try and understand what you need to do and what tools you have to do it. Oh, and once you're done, give yourself a high five. You deserve it.